Dear friends, today we are discussing inverse of a matrix. Inverse of a matrix. In our last sessions, we discussed about minor of an element, based on that cofactor of an element and a cofactor matrix. When you find the transpose of a cofactor matrix, what we go towards adjoint of a matrix. So let us see how we define inverse of a matrix. Let us find a formula to find inverse of a matrix. We have the property of adjoint of a matrix as A into, for any square matrix capital A into adjoint A is determinant A into I, right? Now, what we are doing is, we are taking the inverse on both sides. That means A adjoint A, the whole inverse is determinant A I, the whole inverse. Now, you better know AB inverse. AB inverse is B inverse in the inverse, known as reversal law of inverses. Then what happens to the left side? A into adjoint A inverse. In place of B, you consider adjoint A. By reversal law of inverses, we get adjoint A, the whole inverse, into A inverse is equal to, right side again, you apply the inverse law, I inverse into determinant A inverse. Now, adjoint A inverse can be written as 1 by adjoint A into A inverse. We keep A inverse itself is equal to I inverse is I itself into determinant A is a value, its power minus 1. So 1 by determinant of A. So directly cross multiplying, you are having the formula A inverse is equal to adjoint A by determinant A. And that's why we discussed how to find adjoint of a matrix A to find inverse of a matrix. So using adjoint of a matrix, we have the formula A inverse is equal to adjoint A divided by determinant of A. What's the limitation in that formula? Now we have the formula A inverse is equal to adjoint A divided by determinant A. Right side is a fraction, is a rational. You see what the denominator is. Denominator is determinant of A. Determinant of A is a value, you know. That determinant of A being a value should not be zero. Therefore, inverse can be found for a square matrix only if determinant A is not equal to zero. So for the primary and the foremost thing to find the inverse, you have to evaluate the determinant of the given square matrix, and if it is not equal to zero only, then only you can proceed to find the inverse. So for the limitation is that determinant A is not equal to zero. If determinant A is not equal to zero, such a matrix A is known as a non-singular matrix. Therefore, the limitation that inverse of a matrix exists only when the given matrix is non-singular. By non-singular, what we mean is determinant A is not equal to zero. Therefore, to find A inverse, the two steps are, first to find the determinant of A. If it is not equal to zero, you find adjoint of A. Then divide adjoint of A divided by determinant of A. You know adjoint A will be a matrix. A matrix divided by a number is such as scalar multiplication of a matrix by a scale, means number. Adjoint A by determinant of A. Let us see some properties. Properties of inverse of a matrix. A into A inverse is I, which is same as A inverse into A. Determinant of A inverse is 1 by determinant of A. We are expecting such one mark questions. Determinant of A given, find the determinant of A inverse. Directly you have determinant of A inverse is 1 by determinant of A, or determinant of A is same as 1 by determinant of A inverse. They are reciprocals of each other. Now, this was discussed earlier. Still, for to remember, determinant of A inverse adjoint A is determinant of A power n minus 1, where n stands for the order of the matrix. And determinant of A into adjoint A is determinant of A power n. Look at the last two, don't get confused. Determinant of adjoint A is determinant A power n minus 1, and determinant of A into adjoint A is determinant A power n.